Was it was it Tinder or was it like the bar?
So like I started getting like a little traction on TikTok at the time. So I was getting a lot of DMs and I was like, yeah, let's go out. Yeah, let's go out.
Fucking fans.
Yeah. And then it was, yeah, I'm a fucking fan. Yeah, Tinder too, but like not really dating apps at all. It was really more just DMs. Kind of just going from there. And they all reached out to me. So it wasn't, I'm a big advocate on not DMing first. Like I do not DM first. That's one of my main things. So yeah, it was like them reaching out to me because I kind of like feeling like I have the upper hand a little bit. So
yeah, but most times it's girls that are getting hit up the fuck ton. But it's rare when like the dude's getting hit up a ton.
Yeah,
right.
It's nice.
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah, it's nice looking at the DMs after this trip too. I was like, dang, you're in LA. I see you're in LA.
So if we're talking a triple digit body count, there has to be some times where you're at like a party or a bar or something where you have a like multiple girls that you've hooked up with at the same place.
Yeah.
And yeah. I call it obstacle avoidance. So that's what I call it, is that it's obstacle avoidance. So when you see someone who's there and then you see someone else who's there, that you got to avoid whichever obstacle.
Yeah, you should have a three-way.
Yeah, I wish. I just kind of play dumbass, like oblivious the whole thing, and it just kind of works for me.
Act like super blacked
out. Yeah, exactly. Like, oh, what's going on? Like, I'm just drinking. What's going on? Like, you know,
do you think you could do that here in LA? Because LA,
see, that's the thing. I was talking to fucking Harry Giles. He fucking, and he's in like that type of shit, like fucking around. And he was like, just telling me stories. Like, damn, that like, I don't know if I could do that here. Like, it's all these like big name chicks and stuff. So I was like, nah. I was like, maybe New York. I'll go back to for a little bit. Yeah. But
he's hooking up with like huge.
Yeah, he is. He's a great fucking dude. He's cool too. But yeah,
Yeah, it's a different implication when you realize, oh, the person that I'm hooking up with has 600,000 fans that love them to death.
Yeah.
Right?
That was like before all this TikTok stuff, like when I was going on all these dates and stuff. So I haven't even like, I'm almost like too like afraid to go out now because they're going to be like telling stories like, oh, he got shit faced at the bar. And was like shoving my fingers down his throat and stuff. And I was like,
yeah, what's up with that, bro? Why even?
I don't know. It's just something I've always done. And like, I just have.
You've always done it.
Yeah.
When was the first throat finger?
I don't know. I'm always like into like spitting in the girl's mouth and like choking them. Like if they're okay with it, I don't like do it against like. That's like.
hey, good for you.
Yeah.
Hey, good for you, man.
I try not to get like too like.
Yeah. Describe your TikToks. So you've been like, I saw one that, where you spit in someone's mouth.
Yeah. So yeah, I actually want to talk about this. I actually have
a few TikToks I want to talk to
you
about.
I got a few. I did a TikTok where I did a drink, took a shot of tequila or something, grabbed a girl by her throat, spit in her mouth, and I just got so much hate for it.
Really?
I got so much hate for it. Like, people were just pissed at me. Like, who does that? 2 weeks later, it's the biggest trend on TikTok. Oh, spit in your mouth. I'm like, come on. And like, all the comments were like, see what you did to turn Tony? And I'm like, whatever.
So you got hate because of that?
Yeah, and then I also got hate when I spit in my grandma's mouth, but that's like understandable. I spit a raw egg in my nanny's mouth. It wasn't supposed to go in her mouth, but that was the take. We're like, we're not redoing it. So we just kept it.
Dude, your grandmother's so cool because like I think about our grandma. Like my grandmother wouldn't do anything.
Oh, she's
so off with me.
Cool.
That's
she shows up. She
like beer bongs faster than like half of this fucking crew.
She's nuts. She limps in because she's got bad legs. She's 80 years old. Limps in. What are we doing today, Tony? I'm like, this is the script. And it says like she's got something like you have to say pussy, bitch, fuck. And she goes, Anthony, I don't want to say this. I'm like, all right, you don't have to. All right, I'll say it. Let's do this. And I'm like, all right. She's a good sport. She fucking loves
it.
Is
it like she was retired and she did, this is her like, I just want to have fun and film TikTok?
It's like her second life because she didn't party at all.
Okay.
So she was never like this. She was never like doing stuff, anything like this. Her husband is actually the guy who got me, my papa is actually the guy who got me started in doing videos. Okay. So he like loves it, seeing it. But yeah, we call it her second life because she never had anything like this.
That's awesome. And did she get recognized a lot? I feel like.
Yeah, it's so funny. She's like the sweetest little lady. She gets recognized. She was at the dentist one time and some lady was fixing her teeth and she goes, I have to show you something. And she was like, what? And the lady takes off her shirt. And she has a two-turned nanny.
No way.
T-shirt on. And my nanny was like, just went flush red. I was like, oh my God. It's just really cool. Yeah, like, she gets noticed all the time. She doesn't really like know how to handle it because she's just like, hi. And she's like, she goes beat red.
That's amazing. Yeah. That's awesome. How's merch been? Like merch, you can have.
Oh,
like,
merch is my favorite. I love doing merch. I take a lot of pride in my merch because I've always had like the vision since I was little. Like, oh my God, I want my face on a shirt one day. Like, how cool would that be? Like, and have slogans and stuff. So I love like posting like, hey, I'm doing a design contest. Who wants to enter? And like just going through the people who like, there's so many fucking talented people out there, yeah. artists. So just going through that and looking at their work and I'm like, hey, can I use this? And like yeah. make something work. That's really cool.
What's your,
I was going to ask you about TikTok too. So I remember like right around like when you like do edit us, yeah. there was a, you were doing like an ass luge on someone.
Yeah.
And I remember you got pink eye.
Yeah. I get pink eye all the fucking time, dude.
So is it from eating ass?
No, or is it just sometimes, just but not usually. No, it's just
how
like,
many times have you gotten pink eye from eating ass?
Probably like twice.
Three times. How many times have you just gotten it?
70.
What? Why?
Dude, I get pink eye. I have the most sensitive eyes I've ever met in my life.
Do you think the pink eye was from, because you got goggles on?
Yeah. Yeah. I got to just the point snuck where in I was there. Just wearing fucking goggles for my videos. So like, because I was like doing the curling the girl's asses in my face. So I was like,
oh, it was super epic. It was an epic video, of course. But then I remember like 2 days later, it's like this dude got fucking pink eye. He got shit in his face.
Yeah, I get it all the time. Because I had like even old clips of me before I even did TikTok. Just Snapchats going through my Snap stories. I'm like, oh, I had pink eye again this week. And it was just like, for one point, it was like 8 weekends in a row. I was getting like healing from it and then getting it again. My dad, there's a video like my dad coming and he goes, see, Anthony's been eating ass again. He's just like, my eyes just like bulge out of my head.
How open were you with like everything that you're doing with your parents? Like,
oh, they completely know open. My mom knows almost too much about me.
She knows about all three digits.
Yeah, she knows about everything.
How are you able to like? How did that happen? Like when you're younger, they just didn't give a shit, or
no. My mom did not like me for a long time. Like, of course she loves me, but it's just like, get the fuck out of my house. Cause I would never want a kid like me living with me. Like I'm 24. Like
an ass getting pink eye.
Yeah. Just partying and like, ugh, I would hate that for me. Like to have a child like that. And I probably will, unfortunately, but, yeah. So she's finally like accepted it and like come to terms. Like that's who he is. That's how he's going to be. That's part of his brand. He's a psycho. He just does weird shit. And I have to sit back and watch.